What's up everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today we are getting stuck into some healthy snacking options, and not just any snack, my favorite thing in this world, a healthy granola. So not only will I show you my favorite basic healthy granola recipe today, we'll also look at some really cool ways that you can incorporate it into your diet. We'll also look at the nutritional content of our beautiful, delicious homemade granola versus the shop-bought stuff. So the beauty about this healthy granola recipe is that we're not adding sugar. Your agave or your honey acts as that sweetener. A lot of recipes do contain sugar, oftentimes brown, and I just feel like it's totally unnecessary. You're also going to get that sweetness from the dried fruit at the end, so it really does not need anything extra. I have everything laid out and ready to go as usual, so let's get stuck in. The first thing we're going to do, as always, is to preheat our oven to 165 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, so the recipe and all our ingredients that we're going to use today are listed in the description box below. Don't be afraid to chop and change in whatever way suits you. For today's recipe, you're going to need 150 grams of porridge oats, 75 grams of pumpkin seeds and 75 grams of sunflower seeds, 100 grams of slivered almonds, 50 grams each of dried cranberries and dried raisins. You can use sultanas if you prefer. A half a teaspoon of vanilla essence, a quarter teaspoon of cinnamon, and a quarter teaspoon of salt. Lastly, for your wet ingredients, you'll need a quarter cup of agave, choosing your substitute however it suits you, and 2 to 3 tablespoons of a neutral vegetable oil. So now we've looked at our ingredients, the first thing that you're going to want to do is get all your dry ingredients combined in a bowl. So you're going to add your oats, your sunflower seeds, and your pumpkin seeds. Your flaked almonds. You're also going to add in your cinnamon and salt. All we want to do is give that a nice mix up together. It already looks amazing. The only thing to remember with this is that you don't add your dried fruit until last because they do tend to burn. It's like if you overcook a scone with raisins, you end up with black charcoal-y raisins that don't taste that good. So we will wait until the granola is fully cooked through and out of the oven before we stir through our dried fruit. So we just pop that to one side, grab a clean bowl, and we're gonna mix our two wet ingredients. Today I've just used vegetable oil. It's completely fine if you want to use a coconut oil or any other oil that is non-flavored, but of course you can use a flavor if you fancy. I almost forgot my vanilla essence, which would be criminal. Add about half a teaspoon of vanilla essence to your wet ingredients. For this recipe today, I'm going to use agave. You can also use honey, you can use maple syrup, or you can use golden syrup. I find agave and honey to be the best options if you're looking for a healthy granola. What you want is a sticky medium that's going to combine everything together and coat your granola really nicely. So once that's all combined together, you're going to add your wet ingredients to your dry ingredients and give it a really good mix up. And if you feel like you don't have enough, you can always add more agave, more honey, or more oil. For me, I usually like to add peanut butter, but since I'm on my New Year, New Me health kick, I've decided to cut back a little bit on the peanut butter, so we won't be adding that in today. But it's completely optional if you'd like to add that little bit of peanut buttery goodness. So I've given everything a really good mix, and to me, that looks like the perfect amount of all my wet ingredients. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab my baking tray, which I have lined already with some greaseproof paper. If you don't have greaseproof paper, that's totally fine. Just make sure you give your baking tray a brush with some butter or some oil so that your granola does not stick. All we're going to do is spoon the granola out onto the tray. Oh yeah, you can see all that stickiness in the bottom of the bowl, which is great. So just press the granola evenly over your baking tray to make sure that we get a nice, even bake. Just a little fun fact in case anybody is wondering, the difference between muesli and granola is that muesli is not baked. So there's your fun fact for today. That looks really good to me. So all we're going to do now is pop that into the oven for about 10 minutes. And then after that first 10 minutes, we'll give it a little bit of a shake up and leave it for another 5 to 6 minutes, just until it's nice and toasty and golden. Burnt granola will start to smell like popcorn, which we definitely don't want. We want that lovely honey flavor, honey smell to start coming from the oven. And that's when we know it's done. And this is what we are left with. Beautiful, toasty, golden granola. So let's have a close up. Absolutely gorgeous, all those colors are. You can see it's just a nice, golden to golden brown color. It's not overdone. You can see the almonds are nice and toasted, as are their sunflower seeds. So all we're going to do now is allow that to cool completely before we add through our fruit. I have to say, I'm absolutely over the moon with how that has come out. I'm really excited to try it. I'm trying not to eat it now. Okay, so everything is really nice and cooled down. All that's left to do now is finish off our beautiful, healthy homemade granola with some dried fruit. So I have my dried cranberries and I have some sultanas or raisins. Today I'm using raisins and we're just gonna add them to the mix. As I start to mix this through, you can really see why we wouldn't really add a whole ton of extra sugar. There's a lot of sugar and sweetness provided in the agave, and there's a lot of sugar and sweetness provided in your dried fruit. You really don't need to add any more. Of course, it's your own preference, but you know me, we like to go for healthy, good options that all the family can eat. And most importantly, recipes that we don't need to feel guilty about enjoying. So before we look at some really easy ways that you can incorporate granola into your diet, let's compare the nutritional value of what we've just prepared with a traditional shop-bought granola that has very similar ingredients. If there's anything that this comparison shows us, is that homemade is the way to go. One of the best things about this recipe for me is that there is 0.00% palm oil, which you would be surprised to find is in a lot of the shop-bought granolas. This is a win-win for me. Even though the calories are fairly similar, you can see as you look along the nutritional content how much better our homemade granola is for us. So looking at that comparison of nutritional information, you can see just how beneficial it is to take that 30 minutes at home and make your own granola. It will make all the difference to the sugar intake of your family. We know that in our modern diets, we are consuming a lot of hidden sugars, and making your own, you know exactly what's in it. You have complete control of the ingredients. And in my own personal opinion, that is the best thing that you can do for yourself and for the rest of your family. So now let's look at four different ways that you can add this granola to your daily diet. One of my favorite ways to eat this gorgeous granola is to have it with some Greek yogurt and some beautiful fresh berries. A second really simple way to eat your granola is to have it as a breakfast cereal, simply with some milk. Quick, easy, and effective. A third great way to eat your granola is to pre-portion it out into individual snack sizes. I like to pop a lid on these and throw them into my handbag so I can eat them on the move. The last and probably my favorite way to eat granola is part of the toppings on my smoothie bowls. Just look at all those vibrant colors. A little sprinkle of granola just adds that extra crunch. Okay everybody, that brings us to the end of our healthy granola recipe. I really hope you enjoyed this video and that you get some inspiration from the couple of little recipe ideas that we've gone through in this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and hit subscribe. And I hope I will see you in my next video. Bye!